Hello traders, Gary Wagner here, just around 11 o'clock in Honolulu, 5 o'clock in New York. It is Wednesday, the first day of May 2019, and this is the Daily Report for Gold and Silver. A whipsaw market in U.S. equities as well as gold and the U.S. dollar as the statement is released from this month's FOMC meeting, taking gold slightly higher and propping up U.S. equities. And then a half an hour later, Jerome Powell takes the podium and the press conference itself results in a dramatic sell-off in gold and U.S. equities. Specifically in the first 15 minutes, we saw gold really plunge, and we'll look at that when we pull up our technical studies. But as of fixed pricing, the net result is that gold did close lower on the day, off by $7.50, currently at $1,278.20. That's a decline of just about 0.6%. Silver lost almost 2%, a total of 29 cents, and closed at 1469. Platinum about 2.5% at 869.20, and that's a $22 decline. And then palladium also dropped lower on the day, giving up over 3%, $42.60 at $1,340.10. It's a most interesting day, and we'll start our technical studies by looking at a 5-minute gold chart. Traders, a very interesting reaction to today's conclusion of the FOMC meeting. And to illustrate that point best, I am pulling up a 5-minute candlestick chart in which I have highlighted two key areas: the area when the FOMC meeting concluded and their statement was released, that of course was 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and this 5-minute candle is what formed immediately during that period of time. The other key point to look at is the first 15 minutes immediately following the initiation of the press conference that Chairman Powell held. And here we can see for 15 straight minutes, the market moving from approximately the daily highs to the low. And what I find most fascinating about today's activity is the initial reaction to the statement, which was that the Federal Reserve had voted in a unanimous vote, 10-0, that they would leave interest rates where they were, the Fed funds rates. We saw gold actually spike up. We saw a little bit of pressure in the dollar, and we saw a firming of the Dow Jones, S&P, as well as the NASDAQ. However, as Chairman Powell read a short, brief statement and then took questions from the press, we saw a dramatic sell-off in gold pricing in the first 15 minutes, in which it sold from about 1288 down to these lows just above $1,274. Following that, we saw the market stabilize and firm up just a little bit, closing a little over $3 off of the intraday lows achieved in the first minutes immediately following Chairman Powell's press conference. One other interesting factor looking at this extremely short-term chart is volume, because we can see these enormous spikes that come in first as the market moves up a little bit, a lull in volume until the press conference begins, and then yet a secondary spike as the market sold off. Traders, I've just pulled up a daily chart of June gold. In this chart, I have three different moving averages, the 50, 100, and 200 day, along with a Fibonacci retracement series. When we look at this chart, there are a couple things that are quite clear. The first thing is something that we talked about yesterday, and that is this convergence of the 50 and 100 day moving average. As I said, it's an extremely lagging indicator, and this convergence is really detailing this move down that came in prior to a small clip up mid-April for about 2 weeks. And the second thing that we notice that is extremely prevalent in the market is the defined and narrow trading range that gold has been caught in. We talked about having really strong resistance at 1291, and that, of course, is based upon the 0.38% retracement. We also talked about some support in the market, and that comes in at the 0.50% retracement at 1272. However, the fundamental news that came out, I believe, is going to favor the short side of the market, meaning the sell side. And I believe that it might be likely that we see gold pricing actually break below 1272. Now, if in fact that does happen, the basic target that I would be looking at would be the 0.618% retracement, and that particular retracement comes in just above $1,250. Below that is $1,230, and that is composed of the 0.78% retracement. I don't believe gold will go that deep, but I do believe if we get any kind of an effective break below this current level of support, at 1272, we will see the market decline in terms of pricing approximately another $20 before we should look for some sort of potential support, which would come in at approximately $1,250. For that reason, I am recommending that we maintain a neutral stance and look to see if this market wants to break below this particular price point to initiate a sell or short position in the market. However, traders, when you compare the sell-off today in gold, which was about 0.5%, and compare that to palladium, which had the largest percentage drawdown on the day, almost 3%, a $39.90 decline is what the market is currently fixed at, and that puts it at 1342.80. But to me, what is most noteworthy in the marketplace today is the break below what I believe to be a area of significant support, former support, I should say, and that occurs just along this channel of the 100-day moving average. We talked about the fact that after the market sold off, this is again at the end of March, we saw pricing pretty much hug the 100-day moving average and then not be able to, with any effective time parameters, close above it. We did have one close above it, and the following day it opened above it but closed substantially below that. And that occurred, of course, this week on Monday. Then yesterday's activity, it opened and closed above the 100-day moving average, although it dipped below it during the intraday low. What we saw today was entirely different. The market sold off severely and, in fact, at its low, traded to 1303.60. So 1300 might be a level of support that it found, and the market firmed up a bit, but most importantly, it closed below the 100-day moving average. And that, to me, is significant because it's the first occurrence of a close below there. We've had the market trade below there but then firm up during the day. And that tells me that we're probably going to see palladium not only drift back to these lows, but we might want to look at the 0.618% retracement, which comes in at $1,255. That would be this particular retracement level right here. And that would be a pretty severe sell-off from these highs of 1580. And that, of course, is a historical record, the all-time high for palladium pricing. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We will talk to you tomorrow for the next daily update and review. Bye-bye.